Apparently, Dax has been searching for this song for 5 years, so this is gonna be a deep one. Let's jump right into it. Dear Alcohol, I don't think you're as bad as they say. Everything else in this world is temporary, so why does it even matter if I drink anyway? Pool of alcohol, Miller Lite. I'm feeling the vibes already, the chills.
I got wasted cause I didn't wanna deal with myself tonight. My thoughts get drowned until I feel alright. I keep drinking till I'm someone I don't recognize. I got wasted cause I didn't wanna deal with myself tonight. My thoughts get drowned until I feel alright. I keep drinking till I'm someone I don't recognize. I got wasted.
Okay, the thing about this is extremely relatable to many of us watching this, right? Whether you went through it or are going through it now or know someone that is going through it. But yeah, so far, the opening of this song, definitely a deep one. Dax is singing about how you change as a person when you start drinking alcohol, you know, when you get intoxicated. Depending on how you're wired, depending on how you are mentally or how stable you are, alcohol's the effects of it can be extremely unpleasant. And unfortunately, alcohol, over drinking and getting drunk and just, you know, you see videos all of the time, especially of the young kids and within music, of the promotion of alcohol as kind of like a sport, right?
I keep drinking till I'm someone I don't recognize. I got wasted. Repeat the cycle every day. I gotta start with a drink. My life been getting sorta crazy and I don't wanna think. I look myself right in the mirror and I don't even blink. Then I get angry, take the rest and pour it right in the sink. I know where this road goes. Alcohol ain't my friend, but I keep drinking cause these demons roam and follow me around everywhere I go.
Okay, so I don't know if you guys saw that, right? Right here.
We take the rest and pour it right in the sink.
Right there.
I know where this road goes.
So he took the rest of it. I'm just trying to, you know, break it down as best as I can. Like when you have a problem and you look at yourself, you think about it, you probably get angry. And then that problem that you have, whether it's something physical or that you can touch, you know, you start to throw it away. But because of the addiction, as you saw, as he was pouring it out in the sink, he also took a drink at the same time. So a part of you is like, that monkey on your shoulder is like, hey, we need to stop. But then the other guy is like, yeah, but that battle within yourself is so hard on anything that you're addicted to. Sometimes it kills me when I see people make fun of someone for being addicted to drugs or alcohol or pornography or video games. It is not just as simple as turning it off and walking away. Not everyone can do that.
Angry, take the rest and pour it right in the sink. I know where this road goes. Alcohol ain't my friend, but I keep drinking cause these demons roam and follow me around everywhere I go. It clouds my mind and soul, it turns my heart cold, but I keep drinking cause it makes me feel like I'm not alone. I'm having problems, my problem, let me reach out. Looking at this bottle, having nothing but doubt. Don't wanna drink, but it keeps coming around and around and around. I got...
Okay. He said a few things here that I like to touch on, right? Just like this song that I listened to recently of Falling in Reverse, Popular Monster. What he was saying in that song was he felt like he was alone. The doctors, the therapist, friends, just people in general were telling him, you're going through a phase, right? So who do you have to turn to? Who do you have to go to when everyone who's like professional that was supposed to help you can't help you? And maybe the people around you are the same demons that are causing you to stay in this rut, right? So what Dax just said here is he feels like he's alone. When you feel like you're alone, who do you go to for help? His pride won't let him ask for help. How many of us have had a problem, or whether it's not even this serious of a problem, where you're like, nope, not gonna ask for help. You're lost in a store, not gonna ask for directions. Pride can do amazing things for you, but then it can also harm you in many ways. So yeah, Dax is touching on some topics here, and I appreciate that for you being so open and able to just say this out. A lot of artists are going through this, right? They're not just celebrities and making money. They have problems too, just like the rest of us, and I like that you're expressing it here.
But it keeps coming around and around and around.
I got wasted cause I didn't wanna deal with myself tonight. My thoughts get drowned until I feel alright. I keep drinking till I'm someone I don't recognize. I got wasted. I got wasted cause I didn't wanna deal with.
You know what's funny about that there? Although he's floating in the air, you know, he's wasted, not himself. It's like he doesn't have control of his body right here, right? But he's still managing to hold on to that alcohol. That addiction is that strong.
I got wasted cause I didn't wanna deal with myself tonight. My thoughts get drowned until I feel alright. I keep drinking till I'm someone I don't recognize. I got wasted. I know I need to quit. I gotta do better. Example to these kids. Cause they watching when I'm there. But I'm scared. Cause I've been chasing the man that I am when I start to drink.
Not devil's advocate, but I'm gonna touch on a topic that many people like to mention. Here's the thing here, right? Cause you know, music, like movies and things like that, are meant for entertainment for the most part, I think. But when it comes to music that's constantly speaking about, let's say, lean and alcohol and weed and stuff like that, it's like you can still play that card that it's just for entertainment. Whoever does whatever the musicians say, they're responsible for it anyway. But with that being said, it's also like with your music constantly saying that, it becomes like a social norm for the people who were actually listening to it, and it looks lit and I want to be lit. I don't want to be a lame-o. It's like a very difficult thing. But for Dax to say, I know kids are watching, he's conscious of that, and he words this, and I'm assuming his other songs, carefully so that he doesn't falsely lead the youth watching him in a bad direction. What do you guys think about that? Do you think it's a responsibility of the listener to not follow what the person is saying?
Scared, cause I've been chasing the man that I am when I start to drink. He's cocky, confident, and he don't give a damn what you think. This world is beating me down and it's pushed me right to the brink. I take a shot every time because man, it helps me escape. I'm taking care of these people, but no one takes care of me. I wanna talk to somebody, but I feel no one relates. I need better now. I think I've lost my. I'm having battles with faith. It's painted right on my face.
God damn, Dax. This one, oh my God, this song is a good one. This is, I'm going to have to listen to this back again. Sorry for pausing again, but this is what he said, right? He takes care of everyone, but no one takes care of him. Going back to him feeling like he's alone and also his pride stopping him from asking people for help, right? As you guys know, if you're that one person or a friend group or a family that usually is the rock for people, it's hard to ask for help, or it's hard for you to be vulnerable in front of those people, because in your mind, you think they always expect you to be perfect and on point and never to need help. So when you do get in that zone, you're like, I don't want to seem sad and depressed because I don't want them to feel sad and depressed.
Help me escape. I'm taking care of these people, but no one takes care of me. I want to talk to somebody, but I feel no one relates.
Yeah, that stems right back to the pride thing. I think it's pride and also embarrassment too, because if you're prideful but you're embarrassed at the same time of the addiction you have, you're probably never gonna tell anyone about it.
Takes care of me. I wanna talk to somebody, but I feel no one relates. I need better now. I think I've lost my way. I'm having battles with faith. It's painted right on my face. I hope better times are coming. No chase, but I'm still running. I gotta take control, and I won't stop for nothing. Dear God, this is my test. Promise that I do my best. Just heal me with this pain. I feel in pressure that is on my chest. I got wasted cause I didn't wanna deal with myself tonight. My thoughts get drowned until I feel alright. I keep drinking till I'm someone I don't recognize.
Look at that pool of alcohol. This is people's reality. This is what I like about songs that are extremely relatable. Like when Tom talks about this stuff, when Dax is speaking about this here, and the other artists that I listen to that speak on you know, real life topics, it is very inspiring, right? Because it shows that everyone is normal, for one, and we all go through these same problems. Let me finish it and I'll give my other statement. Feel alright, I keep drinking till I'm someone I don't recognize. I got wasted, cause I didn't wanna deal with myself tonight. My God, when I don't recognize, I got wasted, cause I didn't. I wonder if that hand in the background that's against the sheet is himself trying to reach him and pull him out of this addiction. Not sure. I don't wanna deal with myself tonight. My thoughts get drowned until I feel alright. I keep drinking till I'm someone I don't recognize. I got wasted. Their alcohol, I found. I already said this, right? Very amazing song. Overall, the message here, being vulnerable to your audience, being open to the people who are watching. I'm not sure how many people do have an alcohol problem that look up to you, but I'm sure this will help them because they realize, oh, it's not just me. I'm not in this by myself. These guys are also going through it. And what I like about songs like this is that maybe the artist doesn't realize it, but when I see these kind of songs, go and check the comments and you will see people leaving their stories. And then those people leaving their stories, other people who are going through the same problem will see those people's stories. And just that alone could help many people say, oh, well, I thought I had it bad. This person was way worse. Or like, oh, this person made it out. I can do it too. So it's like an infinite effect that this can cause in the comments alone. I would wish YouTube would promote things like this, right? Trending is a great thing because of the views, blah, blah, blah. But I think like when something like this comes out, they should put that on trending because it's a very important message for people to see and listen to. And it can help a lot of people. That's my opinions on this. You know, Dax, very respectable artist that I from what I've heard so far and that I've seen him post so far. He goes very deep into his music videos. The production is always great, and there's always a story going on within the video and the lyrics itself. I would love to have like a sit down talk with Dax about this song. If you watch this video, Mr. Dax, hit me up, man. If you down for, you know, a little chit chat about this and the other kind of topics around, you know, being a rapper and a person, family member, you know, where you, I'm talking too much. But anyway, yeah. So send this video to Dax so he can see it. I'm about to sign out. Let me know what your guys' thoughts are on the song.